That's right, Claire, but we don't want to go in debt if we're going to take one of those trips. But unfortunately, a lot of people are in debt, and Stuart Welch from the Welch Group joins us with a strategy to finally get you out of debt. Good to see you this morning.
Morning, Mike.
A lot of these steps are pretty involved, so we want you to follow these here. But if you can't follow them all, we'll have this article also posted to our website. But, I mean, it's overwhelming sometimes how much debt people are in.
It is, and most people have created what I call a pyramid of debt. So there's mortgage debt, and then there's automobile debt, and then there's appliance debt, and then there's store card debt, and then there's credit card debt. It's this whole pyramid, and some of it's relatively low interest rate, and some of it's really high interest rate, and so you want to get organized and attack it.
All right, you got five steps to knock down this pyramid debt, and you call it your reduction strategy. Okay, first of all, the first thing everybody needs to do.
Stop the bleeding.
Okay.
This is don't do any new debt. So I think the first thing is you want to accept responsibility for the decisions you made that got you there and commit to change. So the first commit to change is we're going to do no more debt. We're not going to add to the problem.
So we're not adding to it. Now we got to prioritize how we're going to attack it. Where do we go first?
This is where the rubber meets the road. You're going to get a sheet of paper, and for every single debt, you're going to write down your who you owe.
Okay.
How much you owe, the interest rate, the minimum payment, and then you're going to arrange those. So you get them on separate sheet of paper. If you have 10 debts, 10 sheets of paper, and then you're going to stack them. You're going to arrange them with the highest debt on top and the lowest debt on bottom.
All right.
And then you're going to narrow your focus. That's going to be step number three.
Okay.
You're going to pay the minimum on everything except that top debt. And so let's say you figure I could pay maybe an extra $100 a month. You're going to pay the minimum debt on the top debt, on the number one debt, plus that $100. Once you get it paid off, so you're just concentrating there, once you get it paid off, number two debt obviously becomes the number one debt. Okay. But here's the key. Mm-hmm. The payment never changes. So what you're paying on the minimum on the first plus that $100 is now moving to that second
debt
in the list.
That becomes the priority.
Okay. Yep. And what you'll see is you'll begin to kind of explode your way through that list after a little while.
We know a lot of folks out there saying, well, look, man, I can't afford an extra $100 a month. So, but maybe they're not looking in the right places.
Well, let's say you can't. You start, well, that's actually bring up a great point. So raise cash. Mm-hmm. That's step number four. Do a garage sale. Do you have a boat? A lot of people have boats sitting in their backyard. Yeah. Sell it. Find out things that you can sell, things you can do. Obviously, you're trying to manage your expenses.
Right.
And then you can try to lower your debt. Look at your interest rates. See if you can get them lowered. And you can consolidate, perhaps, but only if you consolidate at a lower rate.
Now, I've heard other places that if you try to negotiate to lower your interest rates, that it actually can hurt your credit score. Is that correct?
Well, I
throw you a curve there.
Yeah, I think that if you call and you try to negotiate, that is not going to hurt your score.
Okay.
Now, if you start moving your interest rates around, changing cards out and things like that, that can affect your score short term. But the main thing is you're not adding new debt. The score doesn't matter as much.
I want to ask you, because you talk about consolidating the debt. Now, in a home equity loan, you're adding debt to the house, though, when you do that.
You could. So let's assume that you did a home equity loan. You got it at a really favorable rate, mm-hmm. and you use it to pay off a bunch of high interest rate credit cards, that actually would be a good thing.
Okay.
So again, you're always trying to move toward lower interest rates and lower payments.
All right. Thank you, Stuart. Good advice. Again, the rest of that will be posted to the website a little bit later. You can take a look at it.